7th March, Sunday. Grace 18. The right anger. The best cleansing of God. Dear friends in Christ Jesus, when you think of Jesus, you don't usually think of him as someone who gets angry, who resorts to violent behavior. We think of him as a tender, compassionate, easygoing person who would not hurt a fly. Yet, our reading for today at first glance seems a bit out of character. What are we to make of what happened that day in the temple? Why did Jesus do what he did? What was the purpose of it? We are going to find it out. The money exchangers and the merchants in the temple in Jerusalem were part of a system that exploited and cheated people, especially the poor. To some extent, these businessmen were necessary in Jewish society. In order to pay the temple tax, devout Jews had to exchange the Roman coins for the Jewish shekels. The Roman currency had images of the emperor on it, and a good Jew would consider it idolatrous to use this money, especially for a religious purpose. But the money exchangers were often notorious cheats who did not give a fair exchange. Furthermore, the poor were required to pay a disproportionate share of the temple tax, which was a regressive tax that favored the rich. In addition, the merchants often sold the animals required for sacrifice at exorbitant prices, and this practice also hurt the lowly. So this is why Jesus was angry in today's gospel. It was powerful anger that was directed not at hurting anyone unjustly, but of stopping evil dealings. Jesus' cleansing of the temple calls us to be more authentic Christians. May we learn to use the emotion of anger to reform our lives in a spirit of joyful but serious penance that will lead us to be willing to drive evil out of our community and the world little by little. Jesus removing obstacles that stop people meeting with God. We can learn two lessons from the gospel. Firstly, anger is not always sin. Jesus was angry, but it was based out of zeal for God's honor. We often get angry when something we love is threatened. Jesus gets angry when God's honor is threatened, and people's ability to come to God is threatened. Secondly, do not stand in the way of the people coming to God. All who seek after God should be welcomed in the house of God and in our lives as well. God has serious issue with those who stand in the way. Jesus is the place where the sinful human meet with a holy God. He is the temple, the way to God. May our church be a place where all who seek will find a welcoming community of people who will love them and help them know God. And may our worship always be from our heart to God's heart and never empty or meaningless. The right anger, the best cleansing of God, is the grace we have for today. Jesus grants us this grace of right anger in order to cleanse evil thoughts and evil actions of ourselves and others. By expressing right anger in a right way and in right situation, we can make people right. Action of the day. Let's reflect on our emotion of anger. Do we have right anger like Jesus? Did we express in right place? Remember that when you leave this earth, you can take with you nothing that you have received, only what you have given, a full heart, enriched by honest service, love, sacrifice, and encourage, says St. Francis of Assisi. Have a graceful day, dear friends.